How's it going, film and TV fans? Welcome back to another review on the Off the Cuff Film Reviews channel. And today we are looking at, or rather continuing our look at, the Halloween franchise with what is considered tied to be the worst film with Curse of Michael Myers from 1995, Halloween Resurrection, released in 2002, directed by Rick Rosenthal, who directed Halloween 2, the original one from 1981. This one's not very good again. It's amazing how, you know, between 1995 and 2002, the three Halloween movies that came out went from shit, actually good again, we fucked a bit again. It amazes me that we can go back to being shit again, because not only does this one kill off Laurie Strode in the first 10 to 15 minutes, it's just fucking terrible because it's some stupid cheesy game show. You've got Busta Rhymes as the as a character in this movie. It is really bad and I really don't like it. It is cheesy, it is cringe, it is dated incredibly with the whole internet, you know, kind of thing. Well, I mean, I know that's not saying much, but like, when you watch the film, you'll see what I mean, where it's fairly dated in its concept and stuff. The characters are bland and boring. The script is very fucking shit. Most of the movies takes place in the Myers house, which, again, is not exactly the nicest location for a film like this. It's one of those films at the bottom of the Halloween barrel that's just really fucking shit that you don't want to remember watching. Like, this is my second time watching this movie because it was on Netflix, so I thought I'd jump the gun and watch it before, you know, I actually had to, and then maybe record my review then and then upload it when at this point when it was needed. But I never actually recorded it because it was so fucking bad, I didn't really want to talk about it until I really needed to, so here we are. And I'm not watching it on Netflix now because it wasn't available on Netflix, so I had to watch it illegally, which is not fun. Anyway, again, Danny likes his score, boring AF, much like the score from Curse, I think, where it was just mostly just jump scare music, whereas with the H2O, the music actually had like a fucking purpose and like actually fucking sounded good and wasn't just the whole fucking time. It actually was, you know, helping to continue the story. This is a really, really shit movie for very obvious reasons. Not one I recommend. Really cringe. Just fucking boring, man. There's no reason to watch this movie other than if you're watching all of the Halloween movies, and then once you've watched it the first time, there is no reason to watch it again, and I probably will never be watching this movie again unless I feel like watching all the Halloweens again. Even then, it is actually to the point where I might just fucking skip this one because there's nothing to gain from watching it. There's just everything to lose. So I would just pretend this one never happens. And then from H2O to Rob Zombie. Case closed. Just don't watch it. And it is really sad that this movie's complete soundtrack is available on Spotify, but Halloween H2O never had a soundtrack release, despite the fact it had some of the best music in the series since John Carpenter's involvement. So first of all, whichever one of you music executives decided not to do that, fuck y'all. Second of all, why are you mistreating my man John Ottman like that? Really? He produced one of the best scores for your franchise since the original movie, and you're just going to not fucking release it at all legally, or at least officially. Fuck you. You know, it's just a stupid movie. It doesn't need to exist. It's boring, it's bad, it's shit, it's cringe, it's terrible. Don't watch it. It's fucking bad. Please don't ever watch it. It has no purpose. It serves no purpose to anyone ever, and I can't be able to talk about it any longer. So yeah, thanks so much for watching. Have a wonderful day, and bye-bye.